What's up, guys? It's Chris Majestic here with Majestex. I've had several people ask me questions about home automation and how I have certain things working in my house. So I want to do a three-part guide on home automation. And the very first video is going to be a general overview, and that's going to include everything you need to know about home automation and what's out there. So stay tuned. All right, so the first thing that you need to know is that modern home automation is usually done with what's called a smart hub. Well, what is a smart hub? Well, a smart hub is gonna be a central connection point for all of the different smart devices that you have in your home. It's also gonna handle all of the configuration and the processing for what you wanna do with home automation. So there are a lot of smart hubs out there nowadays, and it can be a little confusing, but the ones that I normally recommend, I usually recommend one of two to most people. And the very first one is gonna be Samsung SmartThings, and the other is going to be the Wink Hub. Now, both of these have their strengths and their weaknesses, but personally, what I recommend to most people is the Samsung SmartThings Hub, just because it's a little bit more flexible and it allows for more expansion and scalability than something like the Wink Hub. But I normally recommend the Wink Hub to people that want simplicity. If that's your most important thing to you and you don't really want to do crazy elaborate things with home automation and you just want to do some simple stuff, then you can get the Wink Hub. It's really easy to get started with, and it's going to be a little bit more intuitive than something like the Samsung SmartThings Hub. That being said, all the other hubs have their benefits as well, but as far as scalability and interoperability, working with other devices and other smart hubs and things like that, Samsung SmartThings is pretty much going to be the best right now. Now, one thing you need to keep in mind when you're looking at these hubs is that most of them are cloud-based. Now, what that means is that the configuration is actually stored out there on the cloud, and that means that it needs to have a constant internet connection in order to work. Since it's cloud-based and it requires a connection to the internet, if you lose internet connection, you have nothing. So if you're using it in a critical situation like, oh, I don't want to carry keys because I just want to use my phone to unlock my door, if you've lost internet in your house, you can't unlock your door. So you want to have a fail-safe in place, something simple as like a key, just in case you do lose internet and you can't get into your house. So now that you know what the hubs are, when you go to buy one of these hubs, you're usually just going to buy a hub by itself, and then you're like, okay, now what? What you need to know as far as devices is that these devices use certain protocols. Now, I know when I say the word protocol, I lose a lot of people, so don't think that this is really that complicated. It's really not. But basically, the protocol is the way that your smart hub is going to communicate with the devices that you buy. I'll use Samsung SmartThings since that's the hub that I use, and that's the hub that I recommend to most people. So if you buy a Samsung SmartThings hub and you go out there to the store, whether it's Lowe's, Home Depot, you go on Amazon, and you want to buy sensors, the thing to keep in mind is that it's going to be compatible with most of the protocols out there, but the main two you're going to see is Z-Wave and Zigbee. So if you see that it says it's a Z-Wave sensor, like a Z-Wave water sensor or something like that, it will work with Samsung SmartThings. Or if you see a Zigbee device, whether it's like a motion sensor and it says Zigbee, that'll also work. So if you want to, you could actually take something like SmartThings and turn that into an actual alarm, which is going to include things like open and close sensors, whether it's a tilt sensor or motion sensor, all those type of things, and then have it actually work as an alarm system for your house. You can do sirens and water sensor, put that in the basement, and you can buy a water shutoff valve. If there's water in the basement, shut the water off, and whatever you want. There's some type of a Z-Wave or Zigbee device out there that does it. So that moves us on to one of the most popular things that people do with smart hubs, and that's lighting. So when it comes to lighting, you're really gonna have three different options. One is gonna be a new wall switch, or whether it's an on-off switch or a new dimmer. The second option is gonna be a wall outlet. Maybe you have a lamp plugged into the outlet and you just want to switch that on or off. And the third option is really the most common, which is just to swap out a bulb. So maybe you're in your bedroom, you have a lamp there, or you have a light in the ceiling. You just unscrew the regular bulb you have in there, put in a smart bulb or a connected bulb, and that's just going to work through your smart hub. So you have a lot of different options when it comes down to lighting. All right, so that brings me to myself. So what devices am I using? What kind of home automation do I have set up? Well, I use the Samsung SmartThings hub as my central smart hub, and I also have the Logitech Harmony Home Hub. I also have an Amazon Echo as well as an Echo Dot, and I do use that for voice control automation. So that works through the SmartThings Hub as well as through the Logitech Harmony Hubs to control things like the TVs and lights in my house. All right, so I just want to briefly show you, just in case you haven't seen any of my other videos, just some of the home automation tasks that I have set up. So the best way to show you this is going to be with the Amazon Echo, since I have the Amazon Echo linked to SmartThings and the Harmony Hub.
Alexa, open Chris's garage door.
Okay.
Echo, turn on basement TV.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on outside garage lights.
Okay.
Alexa, turn the house alarm on stay.
Okay.
On stay.
Alexa, set the downstairs temperature to 74 degrees.
Setting downstairs AC to 74.
All right, so as you can see, I have all these things set up and they're all working together. So this is where your planning really comes into play. So you wanna make sure that all devices you're buying are compatible with the hub that you're buying and make sure the hubs are compatible with each other as well. So depending on how deep you wanna go as far as adding a bunch of devices and a whole lot of different automation, it can be very difficult to set these hubs up. Now this is where getting a Wink hub over a SmartThings hub actually comes in handy, because the Wink hub is a little bit easier to set up and use compared to SmartThings. Now it is easy for the most part to add devices to either one of these, but when you're setting up your automations, that's when one really shows over the other. So you have to be patient either way. You have to do your research and it's gonna take you some time to get these set up. All right guys, well that's gonna be it for this video. Now keep in mind, this is video 1 of 3, so I'm gonna have a 3-part series. So this is gonna be just a general overview. In this video, I'm gonna go in more details in the other two, but I thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you did, please smash that like button for me. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.